subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world for its culture and heritage. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India's tribal culture speaks volumes about the diversity of the country. Warm hospitality and simple ways of living are some of the traits that mark the tribal cultures of India. To preserve and cherish this culture, a tribal fair is organized every year in Bhubaneswar city of Odisha. Let's take a look at this year's edition.
Showcasing the real tribal culture and lifestyle of Odisha, a 15-day tribal fair was recently held at Bhubaneswar's Adivasi Exhibition Ground. Around 62 tribal groups from different parts of the state participated in the event, wherein they presented their own unique heritage through a wide range of tribal articles, including jewelries, household items, and traditional food products. It provided a major attraction to visitors in the form of agricultural products like cereals, pulses and spices, forest produce, utility items, handlooms and art and craft.
ये हम लोग का जो ग्रुप है सब ग्रुप में जितने लोग हैं 30 लोग हैं और सब मिलके हम लोग बनाते हैं ये हम लोग गांव में बनाते हैं अच्छा डिजाइन ये करके बनाते हैं तो लोग घर सजाने के लिए ये बांस में बनता है
Popularly known as Adivasi Mela, the tribal exhibition showcased the best of tribal products in quality, design and versatility. As a part of the festival, photo exhibition was also organized with thousands of pictures showcasing the hidden traditions, culture and lifestyle of various tribal communities were displayed. Though the festival witnesses a huge rush every year, but this time amid the pandemic, limited crowd was allowed. Visitors were asked to strictly adhere to COVID-19 guidelines, including use of face mask, hand sanitization, and maintaining physical distancing.
ये जो चीज है ये कहीं पर मैंने देखा नहीं ये इधर ही मिलता है और साल भर हम वेट करते हैं इसके आने के लिए तो ये जो क्वालिटी इसका बहुत ही अच्छा है और बहुत ही जेन्युइन प्रोडक्ट मिलता है इधर पे तो मैंने एक चीज लिया वो एक गणेश जी का प्रतिमा ली और दैट इज मींस इट्स एक्सेलेंट प्रोडक्ट व्हाट वी गेट हियर सो दैट्स व्हाई वी कम हियर एवरी ईयर वी वेट टू गेट दिस प्रोडक्ट फॉर आवर हाउसहोल्ड्स
Organized since 1951, the festival aims at introducing people from all over the world to the thriving indigenous cultures of Odisha, be it through their food, attire, or myriad traditions, along with providing tribals with a brilliant platform to market and sell their products. This year, an attempt was made at the fair to move towards cashless transaction by placing QR code scanners at the stalls. Moreover, due to the pandemic, a hybrid approach was also adopted, wherein the fair had a physical as well as a virtual presence, enabling people to both watch and buy products at the comfort of their homes.
सुना ही होगा कि बहुत ज़्यादा डिफ़िकल्टी आने से हम लोग उस डिफ़िकल्टी को लांग कर हम लोग एक नई जीत की ओर जाते हैं। तो मेरे ख्याल से आदिवासी मेला 2021 में भी हम लोगों को उसी एक चैलेंज जब दिया था तो हमने डिपार्टमेंट ने गवर्नमेंट का टोटल सपोर्ट लेकर वर्चुअल एज वेल एज एक्चुअल मोड में आदिवासी मेला करने का एक प्लानिंग किया था एवं उसी की वजह से आप देखेंगे कि हम लोग ई रजिस्ट्रेशन फैसिलिटीज़ कर रहे हैं जो कि आदिवासी मेला 2021.com उसमें आप लोग जाकर खुद भी ई कल्चरल प्रोग्राम अनुभव कर सकते प्लस आप लोग ई मार्केटिंग कर सकते उसमें लिंक दिया गया है सो आप मार्केटिंग कर सकते हैं।
One of the oldest festivals of tribal community, Adivasi Mela is a great platform that is not only helping in preserving the Odisha's tribal culture, but also enabling visitors to explore the intricacies of the tribal lifestyle.
India is a nation that has astounded the whole world with its ability to tie multiple religions, cultures and lifestyles in a single knot. It is the unity showcased by its citizens that the largest democracy in the world stands stronger than ever. One such similar show of unity was seen in Ahmedabad city of Gujarat on the occasion of 72nd Republic Day of the country.
A long strand of saffron, white and cream, which makes up the tricolour flag, ran through the streets of Ahmedabad as people of different communities celebrated the 72nd Republic Day of India. Organised with the motive of symbolising religious harmony and communal amiability, the flag march was carried out by the people of Jamalpur area.
मैसेज देना चाहूँगा जो हिंदू मुस्लिम भाई भाई हिंदू मुस्लिम मिलके आज़ादी लिया है सब मिलजुल के रहो अपना देश का तरक्की हो रहा है और उस तरह ही रहना चाहिए और देश में अमन और शांति होना चाहिए।
More than 150 people of different religious communities gathered for the flag march. The citizens decided to make a 72 feet long tricolor flag to mark the 72nd Republic Day celebrations of India. Citizens gathered at the Jamalpur Darwaza in Ahmedabad and took the march from some of the major attractions of the city like Jagannath Temple and Christian Tekra. Last year, a similar tricolour march was carried out in Ratanpol area near Gandhi Road in the city of Ahmedabad to deliver the message of communal unity and harmony.
ये राष्ट्रीय एकता हिंदू मुस्लिम का एक प्रतीक है और इससे खूब अच्छा पिक्चर जमालपुर मॉल में से पूरे देश में जाएगा और हर साल जमालपुर में कौमी एकता का कुछ ना कुछ रऊ भाई एक कुछ प्रदर्शन करते हैं मिसाल पेश करते हैं।
इट इज ड्यू टू एग्जांपल्स लाइक दीस दैट द वर्ल्ड लुक्स एट इंडिया विद ऑ एंड वंडर्स how the second most populated country in the world resides with such great unity and diversity.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
India showcased its latest weaponry, technological advancements and cultural diversity during the Republic Day celebrations in New Delhi. The parade began after President Ramnath Kovind hoisted the Indian national flag in the presence of Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Apart from military tanks, weapons and missiles, India's cultural diversity was on full display with regional tableau of all states at the parade, followed by traditional dance and art performances. A 122-member contingent of the Bangladesh Armed Forces, including the Army, Navy and Air Force, participated for the first time in India's Republic Day Parade. In another first, a tableau of newly formed Northern Ladakh Territory showcased peaceful and calm people of the territory, proud of their rich culture, now cherishing the federal status. Indian Air Force performed aerobatic maneuvers with Rafale, Su-30 MKI aircraft in various formations.
India dispatched the first batch of homegrown Covishield vaccine consignments to Myanmar, Seychelles and Mauritius to help in their COVID-19 control and treatment programs. India is donating millions of doses of vaccines to a string of countries in Asia, drawing praise from neighbors and pushing back against China's dominating presence in the region. Shipments of AstraZeneca's vaccine manufactured by the Serum Institute of India, the world's biggest producer of vaccines, have already gone to the Maldives, Bhutan, Bangladesh and Nepal. Myanmar was among the countries next in line to get free consignments as India moved before China, which has also pledged to supply vaccines to its neighbor. The two-day annual flower show in Odisha's Bhubaneswar city became the focal point of attraction for the nature lovers as it promised them a visual treat. Organized at the city's Ekamra Kanan Botanical Gardens with a theme based on COVID-19 pandemic and vaccination drive, the flower show flaunted some of the magnificent floral installations.
अभी जैसे हमारे पास यहाँ पे ऑर्किड की बहुत अच्छी कलेक्शन है, हमारे पास यहाँ पे कैक्टाई की बहुत अच्छी कलेक्शन है, फिर एक यहाँ पे जगन्नाथ वाटिका है, तो वहाँ पे जितने भी फूल लॉर्ड जगन्नाथ को दिए जाते हैं उसको सबका करके हमने गार्डन बनाया हुआ है। इसी तरह से हमारे रोजेस का है, मेडिसिनल गार्डन का भी है, उसको हम और करेंगे, तो मेडिसिनल गार्डन की कलेक्शन भी यहाँ पे है। फिर जो वाइल्ड में जो एडिबल फ्रूट हैं उसकी यहाँ पे पूरी कंजर्व करके उसको यहाँ पे हमने रखा हुआ है। तो इस तरह से हमारे मतलब जितनी बायोडाइवर्सिटी है उसको जितना ज़्यादा हम यहाँ पे ला के कर सकें।
इन द वेक ऑफ COVID-19 पेंडेमिक, दिस ईयर एंट्री टू द फ्लावर शो वॉज रिस्ट्रिक्टेड टू अ परमिसेबल नंबर फॉर द विजिटर्स एज अलाउड बाई म्युनिसिपल कॉरपोरेशन ऑफ भुवनेश्वर।
Sufism has entrenched itself at the center of cultural and spiritual life in India. The Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir serves as the richest reservoir of this tradition, and this can be well witnessed during the urs of Sufi saints in the region, when people cutting across religious lines gather under one roof. So, giving a glimpse of this unique devotional culture, today we take you to the Urs commemoration of Dil Mohammed Sahib that was recently commemorated in the Rajouri district of Jammu and Kashmir.
The shrine of Sufi saint Dil Mohammed Sahib, located in the Fatehpur village of Rajouri district, is an abode of peace and tranquility. People cutting across all religious lines gathered at the shrine to attend the Urs of the holy saint. They offered special prayers at the shrine and wished for peace and prosperity to prevail across the nation.
बहुत सारे उलमाए इकराम रजौरी और पुंछ के और दीगर जितने लोग हैं आगे पीछे के, वो इस हर साल की तरह इस साल भी उन्होंने उर्स में हिस्सा लिया। अल्लाह ताला इसको कबूल फरमाए।
As a part of celebrations, Sufi scholars and imams sermoned the public on the life, religious services, teachings and spiritual strength of the saint who devoted himself in service of the public good. Forming an integral part of the public ethos for the last several centuries, even today the Sufi traditions play an important role in the lives of the people and connot them with an understanding of the world in all its spiritual dimensions. Community kitchen or langar was also set up at the outdoors to serve meals as holy sacrament to the devotees coming from different religions.
हाँ, जहाँ आप जाएंगे, जिस मैदान पर जाएंगे, देखेंगे कि यहाँ पर यहाँ रंग नस्ल की बात नहीं, यहाँ किसी ऊंच और नीच की बात नहीं, एक ही जगह बैठ के सब लोग खाना खा रहे हैं और एक ही खाना बनता है और सब लोग बड़ी खुशी से, और इसमें बरकत भी है और इससे शफा भी है।
The Urs commemoration of the Sufi saint and number of devotees coming to the shrine clearly indicates that the lesson of humanity and compassion towards all religious communities is still having its roots deeply embedded in the culture and tradition of India.
The highly competitive market of baking is encouraging the youngsters in the country to build career in this domain and raise the bar. Many among them have already taken their passion for baking a step further by turning it into a profitable business. Joining the league is a Jammu-based young girl, Priyasha Gaur, whose bakery startup has become an instant hit in the region.
As nothing excites consumers more than tempting sweets and beautiful desserts, baking has become a lucrative career option in today's era. Though entering this field may seem to be a little easier, but it requires a lot of creativity, commitment and passion for food. Having all these qualities, Priyasha Gaur from Jammu decided to turn her passion for baking into a business venture. The idea occurred to her during the coronavirus lockdown, and after giving some serious thought to her business plan, she decided to start an online bakery named Bakery. With the USP of natural products, her startup initially focused on making ice creams, but slowly started venturing into a variety of cakes, cookies, and even sugar-free products for diabetics.
लॉकडाउन के ड्यूरिंग करा था. मुझे बेकिंग का बहुत पहले से शौक था. बचपन से आई यूज़ टू ट्राई घर पे केक्स बनाना, किसी ना किसी ओकेजन पे कुछ ना कुछ ट्राई करना. बट अभी जब लॉकडाउन पे हम लोग घरों में रिस्ट्रिक्टेड थे, तब जब एक चीज़ मुझे हम सब किसी को भी नहीं मिल रही थी, वो थी आइसक्रीम्स. तब आई ट्राइड मेकिंग आइसक्रीम्स घर पर, एंड जब मैंने वो बनाना शुरू किया तो मैंने ऑनलाइन उसका पिक्चर्स वगैरह डाली, पेज क्रिएट किया, एंड लोगों का काफ़ी अच्छा रिस्पांस आया उससे रिलेटेड. एंड उसी से फिर वो बढ़ता चला गया. फिर ग्रेजुअली केक्स एंड कुकीज़ और बाकी सारी डिजर्ट्स भी कैटलॉग में ऐड कर दी.
Social media has proved a great help to Priyasha in making her bakery startup a success. By using Facebook and Instagram for the promotion of her products, she has not just managed to tinkle the taste buds of lots of people, but has also successfully built her own customer base.
Is passion related? Mujhe online बहुत हेल्प मिली है ऑनलाइन मार्केटिंग के थ्रू. बिकॉज हमारा जितना भी सारा केक्स का या बेकरी का बिजनेस है, वो सारा आइदर वर्ड ऑफ माउथ है या फिर ऑनलाइन है. तो आई फील कि इस प्रोसेस में ऑनलाइन बहुत हेल्प मिली. बिकॉज लोग देखते हैं, पेज पे देखते हैं, प्रोडक्ट्स देखते हैं, फिर उनको अपीलिंग लगता है, वो ऑर्डर प्लेस करते हैं, एंड अगर उनको टेस्ट वगैरह अच्छा लगता है तो देन दे बिकम रेगुलर. फिर वो आगे से आगे वर्ड टू वर्ड माउथ स्प्रेड होता रहता है.
Throughout her venture, Priyasha's family and friends have been quite supportive and still keeps on encouraging her to work harder.
Jammu mein aisi ice creams nahi thi, natural ice creams aur sugar free ice creams. To fir isko wahan se acha response mila, to fir isne bakery ke liye bola ki main bakery bhi kar leti hu, cakes wagaira, cookies aur wo jo bhi hai. वो इसने किया, उसका रिस्पॉन्स इसको अच्छा आया. फिर इसने गिफ्ट सैम्पल्स बनाना शुरू कर दिए, वो दिवाली और टिक्का, भाई दूज वगैरह पर. उसको काफ़ी अच्छा रिस्पॉन्स आया और मोर ओवर जम्मू से नहीं, बाहर से भी आया. जैसे बैंगलोर, दिल्ली से ऑर्डर्स आए जिन्होंने जम्मू में, उनको जम्मू में डिलीवर करने थे. तो इसको अच्छा रिस्पॉन्स मिला तो इसका मोरल अप हो गया और अब आहिस्ता आहिस्ता ये बढ़ता जा रहा है और इंटरेस्ट शो करती जा रही है ये बीच में. तो हमने इसको कभी रोका नहीं, हमने कहा कि जो आपका पैशन है उसको परस्यू करिए.
जस्ट लाइक प्रियाशा, अ नंबर ऑफ वुमेन फ्रॉम जम्मू एंड कश्मीर आर एंटरिंग इनटू द बेकिंग बिजनेस लेटली एंड आर डूइंग वंडर्स. थ्रू देयर एंडेवर्स दे आर इंस्पायरिंग द यंगर जनरेशन टू टेक देयर पैशन टू न्यू हाइट्स.
Last but not the least, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings across Asia in our new edition, Asia in Focus.
A wildlife park in Singapore released photos and video footage of its first lion cub born from artificial insemination. Simba was born on October 23, 2020, after a team at Wildlife Reserve Singapore successfully impregnated its mother Kayla in July. The father Mufasa, however, did not survive the electro-ejaculation procedure. According to the park, Mufasa 20 did not sear any cubs in his lifetime because of its aggressive behavior, discouraging successful pairing with any females. WRS said Kayla was unable to feed her cub properly and that staff were assisting with bottle feeding, but Simba is growing and is healthy. The mother and son have yet to be introduced to the rest of the family. A lioness in South Africa gave birth to the world's first lion cubs born through artificial insemination in September 2019, the University of Pretoria, which led to the procedure set at the time. Devices designed for improving customer marketing and sports performances are now being used in the fight against COVID-19 as companies deploy their technologies to meet new needs during the pandemic. The annual Wearable Expo in Tokyo showcased a wearable heart sensor which could potentially be used as a monitoring device for COVID-19 patients at quarantine hotels. The sensor made by Company Union Tool can remotely monitor a person's heart rate and temperature, and it's now used for managing people's health and collecting biometric data for sports and exercise. Hitachi LG Data Storage originally developed its 3D LiDAR people counter sensor for retail stores to track shoppers' movements and analyze data in order to improve sales and customer satisfaction. But demand has been rising since the pandemic started. 今までは、やはり動線がついてきているっていうところがあるので、マーケティング用の多かったんですけども、最近で言うと、無人店舗で買って、いろんなところで使っていただいてまして、無人店舗用であるとか、使って、さらに、コロナになってからは、やはり無人化っていうのはかなり結構大きくなってきますし、あと、先ほどご紹介したような、人数制限っていうところで、お店とか施設の、
The technology monitors the number of people and their movements to reduce congestions, and it estimates wait times at cash registers to help reduce infection risk.
It can also determine whether or not a customer has stopped by a specific area, such as a required hand sanitizer station. To shed light on its art and history while supporting contemporary Muslim artists, Google Arts and Culture in partnership with Iraqi community radio station Al Ghat Radio recently launched an online exhibition named The Art and Soul of Musul. The collection will help people immerse themselves in the world of Musul's art through features like detailing painting tours and videos detailing the artist's experience living through occupation. At the heart of the project is the incredible artwork depicting the stories of the city and the people, including the lives of women and children during and after the war.
But the way we were involved in the curation was not so much of trying to tell them to, here is what you need to say, but more about trying to come up with technology formats that they can use. So, for example, one of the things we did is they have these amazing artworks, but how do you get really close and how do you get really zooming into these artworks? So we use our technology.
The Art and Soul of Musul is Google Arts and Culture's latest project showcasing contemporary culture and the ancient heritage of the Middle East. With this new digital exhibition, the art pieces now have a permanent online home.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.